Florida and Alabama may share a border, but state laws can differ. Recently, Florida enacted a new law to help give grandparents visitation rights in some custody cases. A similar law was struck down in Alabama nearly 4 years ago. News 5's Chad Petrie has that story.
This medallion is usually near Richard DeBlaze.
Unless you see a face sometimes, names mean nothing.
Also close is a stack of papers detailing his efforts to try and get a grandparent's Bill of Rights reinstated in Alabama. His grandchildren, Natalie and Chase DeBlaze, were murdered in 2010. The children's father and Richard's son, John DeBlaze, was convicted of their murder last year. And this year, another jury convicted their stepmother, Heather Keaton, of murder. In the months leading up to the children's deaths, Richard DeBlaze says they tried to see the kids, but John and Heather always kept them away.
I would have had the right to be able to see them physically. And that was something I never could do.
Florida enacted its own laws for grandparents' visitation this summer.
While welcomed by advocates, the grandparents' rights law in Florida only applies to a select group of people. It only applies when the child's parents are either dead, missing, or in a persistent vegetative state, or if one of those parents meets one of those three criteria and the other convicted of a felony.
Alabama passed its own Grandparents Visitation Act years ago, but it was eventually overturned in 2011. The state Supreme Court saying the law violated the rights of parents to decide who their children can see. Richard DeBlaze is hopeful something can change.
Well, anytime you can enact laws and legislation that would protect the kids, it's to the advantage of everyone involved.
And it's a law he has close to his heart. In Mobile, Chad Petrie, News 5.